write sigma notation or summation notation for the finite sum, then determine the sum. Let's first analyze the sum to see if we notice a pattern. Notice 4 times 3 is equal to 12. 12 times 3 equals 36. 36 times 3 equals 108. And the pattern continues all the way out to 2916. Because we are multiplying by 3 each time to determine each successive term, this is called a geometric series, and we can use the formulas for geometric sequences and geometric series here to help us write the sum using sigma notation. Because the first term is 4, a sub 1 is equal to 4. Because the pattern is to multiply it by 3 each time, the common ratio r is equal to 3. There's also a formula to determine the common ratio r, given by a sub n divided by a sub n minus 1, which means we can determine r by selecting any term in the series and dividing by the term before it. Notice 12 divided by 4 equals 3, and so is 36 divided by 12 and 108 divided by 36. Now that we have a sub 1 and r, we can determine a sub n, which is the formula that will generate the terms of the series or of the sum. For a geometric series, a sub n is equal to a sub 1, which is 4, times r raised to the power of n minus 1, which in our case is 3 raised to the power of n minus 1. And let's begin to write the sum using sigma notation. We have the summation. Because the variable is n, we have the index starting at n equals 1. The formula to generate the terms is 4 times 3 raised to the power of n minus 1. And now we need to find the upper limit of the index, or the last value of n, which is the value of n that will generate the last term, which is 2916. To do this, we will set the formula a sub n equal to 2916 and solve for n. This gives us the equation 4 times 3 raised to the power of n minus 1 equals 2916. For the next step, we will divide both sides by 4. Simplifying, this gives us 3 raised to the power of n minus 1 equals 2916 divided by 4 equals 729. And now to solve this equation, we could use logarithms, but let's go ahead and write 729 as 3 raised to a power. To do this, we will determine the prime factorization of 729. 729 is equal to 3 times 243, where 3 is prime. 243 is equal to 3 times 81, 3 is prime. 81 is equal to 9 times 9, and 9 is equal to 3 times 3 here, as well as here. Notice 729 is equal to 6 factors of 3, or 3 to the 6th. This gives us the equation 3 raised to the power of n minus 1 equals 3 to the 6th. Because these are equal and the bases are the same, the exponents must be equal, which means n minus 1 must equal 6, and therefore n is equal to 7. 7 is the upper limit of the index, or the last value of n. And now we have the sum written using sigma notation. The last step is to determine the sum, which for a geometric series is equal to s sub n, given by this formula here. Because the index goes from n equals 1 to 7, we know we have 7 terms in the sum, or in the series, and therefore the sum is equal to s sub 7. For a geometric series, this is equal to a sub 1, which is the first term, which is 4, times the fraction, where the numerator is 1 minus r raised to the power of n, which is 1 minus 3 raised to the power of 7, divided by the quantity 1 minus r, which is 1 minus 3. And now we need to simplify. Let's simplify the numerator and denominator of the fraction first. 3 to the 7th is equal to 2,187, which means s sub 4 is equal to 4 times 1 minus 2,187 divided by 1 minus 3 is negative 2. 1 minus 2,187 is equal to negative 2,186. This gives us 4 times negative 2,186 divided by negative 2. And negative 2,186 divided by negative 2 equals 1,093, giving us S sub 7 equals 4 times 1,093. And 4 times 1,093 equals 4,372, which means the sum, or S sub 7, equals 4,372. I hope you found this helpful.